everybody. It's been a long time, hasn't it? I want to personally say thank you to every single one of you who left comments and who sent me messages and everything. Your prayers, your support, everything within the past couple of months. In all honesty, I kind of hit my breaking point during that period, and let me tell you real quick how good God is, okay? Whether you believe in God or not, I think the testimony, which you would have to ask me in private because I won't talk about it here, my testimony alone would make you think twice about if you're doubting if God exists, okay? Because I have a huge testimony. But to keep it short, because I got a lot of great things I want to tell you, but to keep it short, I did have to go and face the young man, which happened Monday of last week. And all the things that I worried about turned out that I didn't even have to worry about it because I knew God had it. In a short summary, it turns out that the whole thing was a conspiracy against me because the bus driver, like I told you in the last video, she and I have a history. And she coached this young man to do what he did. And it all came out in the opening. It all came out just in the open on the day that we had to face each other and during the week. Now, after I won the thing. This was a big victory. I won that thing on Monday. I won the court case on Monday. Won it hands down. And I mean, this was big. This was really, really big because this was different people were in play here that were on my side. And it came out beautifully. and I thank your prayers and all for that because that's what it was. And then, during the week, that's when all of the truth started coming out. We're talking about back and forth to school, to my sister's school, taking it way beyond the educational system. We went really far with it to the point where it could have gotten on television, seriously. And on Friday, which is, you know, everybody loves Friday, that's when the blessings started to unfold. And our phones have not stopped ringing, seriously, from the school. And I've never seen my sister come home happy before from school, since she started school. Those incidents will never happen again. And I'm very happy about that because I think, I'm surprised that many of my friends, even some of you all, have told me that 2010 was just the worst year for anybody. And I'm hearing this from all over the place that many people just, 2010 was just a bad year. And 2011, it seems like everybody, everywhere I look on television, even in music and stuff like that, people are just like, 2011 is it. This is my year. We're going to turn things around this year. And it already, this year has started off on an awesome foot. A great foot, Dr. Scholl's kind of foot. It is just wonderful, and I've never felt at peace. It's been a long time since I felt peace before, and it's just wonderful. Peace and quiet, seriously. That is just it. I can't put it into words. But I thank God first and foremost because without him, I'm telling you, if he showed how real and how his grace and how his blessings was this past week, because this ought to be, my testimony ought to be in books, seriously. It is just, I can't even, it is beyond words. I cannot put it into words. I really cannot. And I, like I said, I thank all of you all for your prayers because your prayers and your friendship have just been what I needed to get through that time, that year. But I'm here. Just like Seeley said on Color Purple, I'm here. I'm here. So I thank you all so much for that. But with that said, getting off that, I do want to say how amazing this year is going to be with all these games coming out, because I have been gaming pretty hard the last 3 or 4 months. Really hard now with the release of Little Big Planet 2, which below I put down under the video here a link to a fan page on Facebook. If you have Facebook, I made a fan page called Little Big Planet Little Big Adventures, which I'm just going to be posting every now and then. Awesome levels that I have encountered since Little Big Planet 2 has come out. I have seen some phenomenal levels. I mean, I'm seeing people Zelda levels. Like, it looks just like Zelda. And I've seen Mario levels. I'm seeing great films. Now you can make films in Little Big Planet, which is awesome, because I would like to make some, you know, in Little Big Planet. I've never made a level before. I started one, but I've never finished it. And so this time, now that we can make films in Little Big Planet, I'm not good at making challenges, but I am good at making films. And you all know this from my Sims film. So now I can actually do my hand in films in Little Big Planet, which is awesome. So that fan page is really just posting up awesome levels that I found, which I still have a lot more to post on there, because since I've had the game, I've encountered a lot of great levels. So if you have Little Big Planet 2, just go to that page down there below and check it out. If you run across some awesome levels, please post them there. So post a screenshot and name the creator of the level and the name of the level, and just share it with everybody, because I'm seeing some awesome stuff. Then we have Brink coming out, by Bethesda, well, produced by Bethesda. That's going to be awesome. We're going to have to buy that the day of. I pre-ordered L.A. Noire. This game is just going, this year is going to be just full of awesome games. And I'm trying to figure out how the heck am I supposed to make a little bit of money to just get them all. So that's part of it, just been gaming. And, of course, we have the Sims thing. Now, I have to confess something to you all. I am not as into The Sims 3 as I used to be. I'm not talking about the franchise. I'm still a big Sims fanhead when it comes to The Sims franchise, the entire franchise. But with The Sims 3, this will be a whole nother post. The Sims 3 in general, really for me, I have just completely lost interest in it. And it all goes to the fact that I had the worst time in the world trying to even play it on my laptop. Okay, things were fine when it first came out. Then all of a sudden, it's trying to overheat my laptop, trying to kill my laptop. You know, it's a huge game with all the graphics and stuff in it, so you can barely have enough space to play the darn thing. Then there's, you can't film in it, not like you really want to. I've seen a lot of Sims 3 movies, but, and I'm trying to figure out how in the world they even have the will to do that, because it's very hard to film in. And I told you all before, I would never film in The Sims 3 anyway, because of the fact that it's forcing us to play the game, which is fine. I mean, that's how the first one and the second one was, which is fine. But they made it so that it would be very hard to do the math of trying to do custom content, you know, hacks and stuff like that, so that you could film in it, which turned me off. Okay. But really it was because just having the trouble trying to run it. And I just got sick of it. So I got the console version, as I showed you all before, and I barely even played that. I mean, that whole ordeal of just having trouble trying to run it on my laptop just killed the enthusiasm of wanting to play it on the console. So I pretty much just kind of gave up of trying to have any kind of hope of enjoying it, The Sims 3. Which I thought I would never say this. I mean, I think the world is really going to end now, because I'm actually denouncing The Sims 3. Are you serious? After the excitement I had 2 years ago about it, now here we are 2 years later, and now I'm sick of it. In all honesty. That, like I said, is not the franchise I'm sick of. It's just The Sims 3. Other than that, I have begun a new production in The Sims 2. A new drama called It's a Guy Thing. And I have gotten a lot of good response for males who want to play the male roles. It's like a, don't want to give my secret away, but it's some of you have seen Living Single, right? The show Living Single, the sitcom, sort of like that, except it's a male version. So that's what it is. So I've gotten a lot of good responses from a lot of guys who want to play the part. And I'm actually getting ready to choose one of the parts for one of the males on there, one of the African-American males named Jamar Bennett. I actually got a big response to play him. Everything else is still open. I still have openings for the other three guys, but I'll post a picture right here in the next couple of seconds. As you can see, those are the three guys. Those are the four guys there. Jamar Bennett, Jacob Williams, Keo Izioy, and Ray Bivens. So all the Ray and Jacob and Keo are the only ones who are actually open right now. I do have one person who wants to play Ray. But everybody in the world is trying to play Jamar. Everybody's trying to play Jamar. These guys were created from Ugly Sims, okay? From scratch by me. And I'm just excited to do these guys. For once, I'm not doing the voices. I'm not doing any kind of voice in it. Maybe like somewhere down the line or something, but I figured it would be nice to do a sitcom directed to my men. Because I do have, male fans who watch my videos, and it would be nice to do something for them. So what I really want to do is talk to a lot of you male viewers. I want to talk to you guys because I know a little bit about what goes through a man's mind when he's around his boys and, they're talking about, sports or girls or women, whatever the case may be. But I really need to be refreshed on this coming from young men, preferably my age, okay? Because the guys that play in this series, they're all in their older 20s. They're all like 25 and 27, most of them. Oh, three of them are. So with that, I'm going to need a little bit of help from you guys, from you men, to tell me exactly what goes through a man's mind in that age range in their 20s. So if you're interested in playing some of the parts, let me know. Okay, let me know. Send me a message here, and I'll send you a message where you could email me your voice audition. The voice auditions actually end Wednesday of this coming week. You can go to my BlaqueEssence Productions page on Facebook. And see there, you can see the pictures of the guys, their names, and their bios, so you can kind of get an idea of who each one of them are, and which one you would like to play, okay? I got a couple of guys who want to play with, who are British, who actually want to play, so I wouldn't mind, if you have an accent, that's great. As long as you can speak clearly, and people can understand what you're saying, and your accent is not as thick, if you can't help it, you just can't help it, but if you can speak clearly, that's fine. You can still send me a message. Like I said, I wouldn't mind one of them having a British accent. It's fine. But I prefer, it doesn't matter how old you are, as long as your voice sounds adult. Because each guy is an adult. So as long as you got that good tone that sounds like an adult, not a young man, that's fine. Okay? So it doesn't matter how old you are. I just need your voices. And that's it. Just want to update you guys, because I know some of you are worried about me and stuff like that, but I'm fine. Doing much better than I have been in months within the past year. So I thank you all again for checking up on me and sticking with me, okay? So you all have a great Sunday, and I will see you guys later.